Hello, Malty Mouth Washes. I'm Ralphie. Welcome to Ralphie Review 706. And my review is of Balvenie 17-year-old double matured, Doublewood as they call it, single malt whiskey from Speyside in Scotland, bottled at 43%. But before I forget, a big thank you to the Swalesdale Bothy for that malt mention. Malt mention credits must be accredited. Thank you, Swalesdale Bothy. Drop of water, not too much, maybe a bit more. That's us. La 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 la. And I'll hold up the bottle, let you see it. Let you have a good swatch, as we like to say in Scotland, a swatch of the label. Mmm. I'm still getting used to this new camera, by the way. I've improved the sound quality by resorting to an older style of microphone called a shotgun microphone that contains a battery to amplify the recording quality. And I have completely readjusted the settings of the new camcorder, HD camcorder, and I did borrow a better quality one to see if it would work any better, and it didn't. So I will prepare a video at some point explaining what recording equipment I've used over the years, or the 8 years, maltmates, 8 years as an online video whiskey reviewer and spirits reviewer. And I'll basically tell you the story about why I chose that recording equipment and all the rest of it and how it worked. But in the meantime, let's concentrate on this Ralphie review. Essentially, what we have here is an older version of Balvenie, which has been moved from the original casks of maturation, being primarily American oak ex-bourbon casks. And it has been additionally matured in European oak ex-sherry casks. Now, of course, what we really need to know here is this just a sherry coating on a partially matured American oak version of Balvenie? Because as time goes on, more and more discerning whiskey drinkers and spirits drinkers, because this applies to rum, not to bourbon yet, but it certainly applies to rum, in that the whole calibre of the experience of secondary maturation is being examined more closely, explored more thoroughly, and what people are finding is that there's a big difference between secondary maturation, transferring a spirit from one cask, style of casks, to another, and finding at the end of the day whether it actually enhances the experience and delivery of the spirit or not. I'll be honest, my personal experience is that there's been mixed results along the way. I think there's two reasons for doing it, and I'm going to explore these two primary reasons later in this review. In the meantime, let's nose this, taste this, and tell you all about it, and finally give it a malt mark. The nose is mildly Balvenie. To be honest, I'm really not getting a clear note of that Balvenie signature, which is primarily fresh fruit and some soft, slightly sweet cereal notes, with a little bit of complexity in the background. I'm noticing a mild sherry note on this, but I'm also noticing almost a syrup note. And I think it's kind of cramping the nose down a little bit. It's kind of lost a little bit of its dynamic, possibly because in its first round of maturation in American casks, it never really picked up that traditional complexity, which is why the reason it would be given additional maturation in European Lamazan, presumably, or Sicile oak casks, which would basically give another layer of flavour. initially the taste is quite sharp. For a 17-year-old whiskey, this tastes more like a 12-year-old whiskey on first contact. This really needs time to settle down and open up. I mean, all whiskies do, but some malt makes more than others. This is a classic example, really, of a whiskey that's a little bit uptight. The arrival sherryish, slightly solventy, slightly mature, undermatured, raisin, some bitter sultana, a touch of wood citrus. You can taste the toasting of the oak that's gone on in the European casks, the European oak wood casks, the sherry oak as they call it. In a sense, it's actually overcoated and slightly swamped, the previous maturation in American oak casks. The development isn't that complex compared to, say, the 15-year-old or 12-year-old cask Balvenies, which frankly are better versions, just saying. In fact, I don't think this is any real advancement in terms of maturation over the 12-year-old Doublewood, and basically many younger versions of Balvenie. And I'd say this is definitely more of interest to not so much whiskey drinkers who go through a lot of different brands for better quality experiences, but for the Balvenie enthusiast specifically, who is wanting to experience all the permutations and versions of Balvenie. Given time in the glass, you will get a quite engaging resinous note, which certainly packs up the development on the palate, which is primarily some slightly sour sherry, soft toffee, some sultanas, some slightly bitter astringent oak, which never leaves the experience, even to the finish. The finish clean enough, it's good. In fact, it's in the finish that you actually start to notice the original Balvenie signature, for which it's deservedly such a recognised single malt. But in terms of overall experience, it really isn't one of Balvenie's finest hours. I'm going to give this 83 out of 100. It's a malt, Mark Malt Mates. Interesting single malt, but in fact, it's one of the intrinsically lesser quality versions of Balvenie that I've reviewed. And this brings us to an interesting point. The old saying that, well, older is not necessarily better. It's certainly the case here, and it's something we have to bear in mind, particularly when engaging with independent bottlings, that there isn't the same care of composition that can go into official bottlings, but then with independent bottlings you tend to get more natural presentations. But with official bottlings, the quality is there, but then it's diminished by being bottled at a lower strength, chill filtered, and then added colourants put into it. And individually they may have a small effect, but collectively they can diminish the experience of smell and taste. And this is kind of something distillers really have to watch out. Whatever you're distilling, wherever you are distilling, one of the first absolute basics that any distillery needs to understand is exactly what is the intrinsic quality of our product, and how best can we create that for our market out there? Because it is the discerning, opinion-forming customers who tend to be the first ones to buy the product. And depending what they say in social media, and depending how much of the conversation is generated out with official marketing constraints is really what's going to make brands or not make brands. Something I mentioned earlier is the whole, you know, reasons for double maturation. And I'm going to come back to that because I really think it's exemplified in this. This is a very good illustrative malt for the fact that distillers will produce double matured whiskies. They will produce versions of their single malts, essentially to cater to not just their one market of their dedicated customer, but to give that customer more options, and importantly, give more options, more flavour and experience variations to the more occasional exploratory customer who will come to that brand from other brands or from other spirits. And the thing about double maturation is that you can find that it will enhance a traditionally matured, the first maturation, the first cask has set the pattern of what that spirit's going to be. But it's the secondary maturation can lift a little bit further if it's done properly, or alternatively, if it's done for another reason. In other words, if the first time casks haven't quite fulfilled their mission in terms of maturation, then the second casks can basically be designed to pull the experience of smell and taste from that, for that whiskey, up to where it should have been in the first place. Now, let me, for the record, state absolutely, I'm not saying that is the case here with this 17-year-old Balvenie. But what I am telling you is that if you can find the single cask 15-year-old version or the 12-year-old version, I'm just telling you, you're going to get a better experience for less cost. And this is the challenge for distillers who are involved with what's called brown spirits. In other words, spirits which are matured in oak wood casks, is that it's not just about getting some solid, jobbing, capable, competent, proactive casks that are going to be maturing your spirit. It's knowing that if you have casks that slightly underperform, perhaps it is better, rather than to put your liquor or the liquor going into different casks, is actually put them into the same style of casks for another 2 to 3 years, where there's perhaps been an interactive shortfall in your first generation of the casks, the first casks used for maturing a liquor. If the second generation of casks are right, if the quality's right, if the standards are good, if you've spent the money to get decent gear, then it's going to elevate the experience given enough time. And the majority of whiskey customers are really, they don't want to go into this sort of detail. They're not that interested. But the reason you're watching this Ralfy Review, Maltmates, the reason you're going that additional miles of spending your time and spending your money on single malt whiskies and other quality spirits is to learn more and more of the smaller detail, so that when you're nosing and tasting a spirit, you have more of an insight, more knowledge to allow you to assess what is right with a spirit and what is wrong with a spirit, and why it is smelling and tasting the way it is. And with matured spirits, particularly as the age, as time goes on, the more time these spirits, this particularly with whiskey, it's malted barley spirits, so the more time it's spending in the wood, quite simply, the more influence that wood, these casks, are going to have for better or for worse. And this is a challenge for whisky makers around the world. And one of the solutions that I'm noticing, which I find very interesting, is the increasing instance now where non-Scotch whisky makers are using alternative woods like chestnut, like cherry wood, and other woods. Elm is being used. Ash, funnily enough, is being used. These casks are out there. They're lying in warehouses. They're part of a longer term experiment. And it's a fascinating experiment because we don't eat wood because we can't digest the cellulose. And we don't want skelfs in our tongue because it's not very nice and we can't digest it. So we don't eat wood. But there is something that we need to understand. And that is in the whole range of woods out there. And it's not just oak. There is a fascinating, complex and substantial array of flavours which, through experience, through the sourcing of quality materials and through the application of experience and intrinsic skills by producers of smell and taste, new flavours can be discovered and bottled, and importantly, within these new flavours will be high standards and intrinsic quality of smell and taste, which dedicated anorak malt mates like ourselves, when we nose it, when we taste it, we will recognise it, we will share it, we will Instagram it and tweet it and generally forum it and talk about it and even occasionally video it. So it's interesting times because we love our Scotch whisky. It's still, in many respects, it sets the standards for many other whiskies around the world. But the world is shrinking and our palates are expanding. And do you know what, malt mates? I'll toast to that. This whiskey now has had another 10 minutes in the glass to open up. And what I'm noticing is resinous, slightly sour, interesting resinous, slightly caramelised sherry notes, which gives me a little bit of insight into the style of casks that were involved in the second part of the maturation of this whiskey. Never a dull moment round here in the Manx Bothy, malt mates. And if you return before too long for Ralfy Review 707, I will be reviewing another single malt, a peated one, again like this, double matured. It's Doublewood. It's a different name, but the same principle. I hope you'll join me. It's all part of the journey, and I'm Ralfy. Bye bye.